The research we're doing here is funded by NASA EPSCoR, and it's a collaboration between the University of Louisville, University of Kentucky, and Western Kentucky University, along with the Glenn Research Center at NASA. In particular, there's a group up there called the Advanced Colloids Experiments Group, and they want to conduct colloidal science on the International Space Station. Now, what are colloids? Colloids is a suspended solution within a liquid or air media. For example, fog is a colloidal solution. Blood with red particles suspended in plasma, that's a colloidal solution. And what NASA is giving us is a unique opportunity to run these experiments on the International Space Station, where there's microgravity, or compared to gravity on Earth, it's negligible. There are many opportunities in colloidal science and with respect to applications. There are applications in solar with respect to optical manipulation, because as the colloids get to the diameter of, we'll say, 1 micrometer or less, you're actually approaching the wavelength of visible light, and below that UV light. So now your physical specimens, the geometry of the particles, is on the wavelength of light, so you can create special prisms, you can create solar panels that have higher energy efficiency based on the materials. And even with the materials, there is some research where they are incorporating graphene particles, graphene colloids, or carbon nanotubes into materials to make them stronger, as well as lighter for structural mechanics, maybe for an airplane wing or a bridge span in the future. But it comes down to the fundamental science of how those particles interact. How can you suspend them in, say, a polymer solution or in a liquid solution for them to form that aggregate or get to that special assembled structure that you desire?